Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Friends, let us start a new chapter called Gravitation. Chapter first start, we'll start with Newton's law of gravitation, but basically gravitation deals with, let me just introduce the chapter. Gravitation basically deals with the forces that any mass will exert on any other mass because of their mutual attraction. It is not that only one mass is responsible for the force of attraction of other mass. The force involves the masses of two objects. This was first thought by Newton. So the law was given, and that was Newton's law of gravitation. So this chapter starts with Newton's law of gravitation. Basically, this law states that if I have two point masses, say M1 and M2, and suppose that these two point masses are separated by a distance, say D, then this law states that this mass will apply a force which is attractive in nature on this mass. That means this mass will pull this mass towards itself, and vice versa. This mass also will exert the same amount of force in terms of magnitude in the opposite direction, that means towards this mass. The force involved is always attractive. So Newton says that the first mass, suppose M1, that will exert force on M2 is given by, suppose the force acting on this because of this mass is force on 2 because of 1. Similarly, the force on mass M1 because of this M2, the force will be attractive and towards this side, and that force is, suppose, F force on 1 due to 2. It says that the magnitude of these two forces are same, but what is the magnitude? This force or that force? They exert equal amount of force on each other, but the directions are opposite. These are called central forces, because the forces act on the line joining two masses along the direction, along the line joining two masses. And the statement is that the force, Newton says that these forces are equal in magnitude, so better we say F. So this force acting on this mass or this mass is given, say this force of attraction is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. This is 1 and this is 2. So if I combine these two, then I have a product of their masses and square of the distance between them. If I introduce a constant, then this constant is known as G, M1, M2 over D square, where G is known as, universal gravitational constant. And its value is 6.67, 10 to the power minus 11. And the unit is Newton meter square over kg square. In SI system of units, it is 6.67, 10 to the power minus 8 dyne centimeter square upon gram square, that you can convert this into, this is in SI system, this is in CGS system, you can convert that. And this force, the statement says that the force of attraction between any two bodies, point objects, is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to between them. The force of attraction between any two point masses is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. This is what is represented here. Product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. This is inverse square law. This law is also known as inverse square law. And in terms of vector, you can see that this is directed this side and this is directed opposite side. So you can directly write that F12 is minus of F21. Obviously, they are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So this is your Newton's law of gravitation. This is the statement. Now, what is the dimension of this G that we write here? Let us see what is the dimension of G. F is G M1 M2 over D square. So G is F D square over M square. F is Newton, that means its dimension is ML T minus 2, force. D square is L square, and this is mass square is M square. This will go up, become minus 1 L cube T to the power minus 2. Okay. So this is the dimension of the gravitational constant. So we have got the dimensions, units and the statement of Newton's law of gravitation. So that's all in this video. Thank you.